we also wait for the coming of the Lord. May this candle help us to recall that even in the darkest of shadows, we are all God's children of light. The second candle of Advent is the candle of peace. As we light this special candle, we remember that peace is possible. God promises that a day is coming when the wolf and the lamb will live together, and the lion and the calf will not be enemies. On that glorious day, Jesus will come to lead us as the gentle shepherd and the Prince of Peace. Third candle of Advent is the candle of joy. Isaiah the prophet delighted in God's promises when he wrote, "The people in darkness have seen a great light, and those living in shadows will have seen a new dawn." The fourth candle of Advent is the candle of love. For all God's blessings, nothing's more precious than love. As we light the love candle, we recall that God loved the world so much that he sent us Jesus, and if we trust in him, we will live forever. Soon we will light the Christ candle to celebrate the birth of Jesus. It will be a glorious time for which we've waited and prepared. God's perfect light will shine in our darkness, and even the deepest shadows will never overcome.
Old Testament prophets predicted the Messiah's birth. They said he would be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Prince of Peace. The true light that could give light to everyone was coming into the world. But when would he come? Where would people find him? And how would they know he was the true light? How would we know if the light came today? Would we take the time to watch? Would we stop to listen? Or would we just be too busy to notice? angel of the Lord appeared, and the glory of the Lord shone all around, and the shepherds were terrified. Then the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy. Unto you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill to all." When the angels had gone away into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. The first men in all of the world to see Jesus were the shepherds. Humble, rough, simple men, yet they were the first. An ancient tale says that the shepherds present to Jesus with humble gifts, such as manna, a little oil, goat cheese, and lamb's wool thrown on it. They were the first common folk, but the Bible says they were first.
Others saw a star too. Magi, visiting from the east, saw the light in the sky and traveled to Bethlehem to find the baby Jesus. God used the star to lead them across many lands, so they could find the true light, Jesus Christ. When they found the Savior, the Magi rejoiced and presented him with the precious gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. After they had worshipped the Christ child, the wise men returned to their villages, and the shepherds returned to the fields, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had seen and heard. So, like the wise men and shepherds, go into all the world proclaiming the good news to all. God is with us, Christ is born.
We wish you a Merry Christmas! We wish you a Merry Christmas!